And whether you agree with it or not, the fact of the matter is that you have got to build your house that way if you want to have your permit approved. So there you go. Let's start with toilets. Like I said, how much room do you need for a toilet? Well, very simple. You need 15 inches from the center line of your toilet in both directions before it encounters anything else. A vanity, a tub, a shower, whatever is mounted next to it. 15 inches in each direction. That means the toilet needs to be centered at very minimum in a 30-inch wide space. That's what you need, 30 inches. Now, in front of the toilet, and this can shift a little bit by municipality, but basically 22 to 24 inches minimum in front of the toilet for why? You know, these things called legs that we have that tend to stick out when you are sitting down on a chair. So, 22 to 24 in front of the toilet minimum, 30 inches centered in that space. Now, you would think, okay, that's pretty snug. Yeah, it is. That's a snug space. We don't rush to 30 inches when we're trying to design a bathroom because, in my opinion, it's a little more snug than is optimal. It works, though. It really does work, okay? When you consider, and we'll get to this in a bit, when you're figuring room around a table, how much room does each person, should you figure each person is going to take up? Yeah, about 2 feet, okay? That's 24 inches. So a 30-inch space for a single person is not the end of the world. It's actually fine. Optimal? What is optimal, Dean? This is not code. This is simply what is optimal, because the code is the minimum. If we exceed it, that's fine. What's optimal is really 36 inches, 18 inches to both sides of a toilet from the center line out. 36 inches is super uber comfy. All right, now, let me address something on the other end, on the other side of that coin, okay, as it were. Something that I raised with Conway when I was talking to him the other night. Something I talked to Jennifer Jones Lee about, and something I've mentioned before here on the show. If you're going to dedicate a space to a toilet, whether it's just getting its own space in the corner of the bathroom, or whether you're going to build a water closet, meaning a, you know, an actual room, a little space just for the toilet itself. Very luxurious, very private, very nice. Okay. How wide then? How much space do you give the toilet then? Well, you might be surprised to find out that even our estate clients with tens of thousands of square feet in their homes, you have to really twist Dean's arm in order to get him to agree to build a water closet wider than 36 inches. Now, sometimes I know, okay, fine, 40, that's it, no more. And I'll tell you why. Going narrower than 30 inches violates the law of the land, that is the building code, okay? Going wider than 36 inches really starts to violate the law of human ergonomics. Now, I'm not talking about space for your body. I'm talking about your sense of security, comfort, and privacy in a space. And I use this radical metaphor. Imagine that you've got all the money on the planet and you've decided to show off to your friends just how big your bathroom is. And your water closet, just the water closet, is going to be the size of a high school gymnasium. No bleachers. There will be no bleachers, okay? You can have a hoop in there if you want. But no, I'm just talking about the size of the water. I know it's ridiculous. Just hang with me. The size of a high school gymnasium. Massive. Now, you're going to be in there behind closed doors. The doors are locked. No window. I mean, you are private. You are in there alone. And we're going to set the toilet in the middle of the floor. How many of you feel comfortable about going over there and sitting on that toilet? Zero people feel comfortable doing that. The space is too big. It's too big. Now, that's an extreme example, but it points out what I am trying to illustrate, which is there is also a limit on the other side of things. Evolutionarily, okay, we are designed deep within our emotional state that when we're in vulnerable situations, like, you know, sitting down with our pants down, we would rather not have tons of space around us. We'd rather be snugged in. So that is why clearance for a toilet inside a water closet is best left to about 36 inches or so and no more, because when the walls start moving out, your emotional comfort starts dropping exponentially with every inch that it goes. Uh-huh. That's the kind of pearls you're getting here. All right. When we return, you know what? We're going to take a couple of calls, and then we'll dive back with some more clearances and dimensions that you need to understand. You're home with Dean Sharp, the house was for Brian Berumenhaus.
The Cal Fire is cracking down on illegal fireworks. State Fire Marshal Chief Mike Richwine says investigators have already stopped an unlicensed fireworks company and seized illegal fireworks from a warehouse in Kern County.
They were found to be in possession of fireworks that had fake or counterfeit state fire marshal seals, and they were in possession of homemade explosives.
California has a zero tolerance policy toward the use, possession, and transportation of illegal fireworks. Illegal fireworks include skyrockets, Roman candles, and aerial shells. News brought to you by Water Heaters Only. The gas tax in California has gone up. The tax increased about 3 cents per gallon yesterday.
I commute 2 hours total every day, so I feel all of the increases.
Drivers in California are already paying the highest prices in the nation for gas. Lawmakers are planning to send out relief payments this fall to help with the high gas prices. LA County Sheriff Villanueva says Operation Safe Travel has been a success. Since June 1st, deputies have made 205 arrests on the metro system, which includes 20 felonies, 169 misdemeanors, and 16 infractions.
And our homeless outreach assigned to Operation Safe Travel have contacted 1,133 homeless over the entire operation.
During the 30-day operation, additional armed deputies were added to regular metro patrols. The sheriff says the added presence of uniformed deputies has helped deter crime and make passengers feel safe. Store in Brooklyn has turned Nathan's famous hot dog into an ice cream flavor for the 4th of July. The parlor accepted a challenge from New York Magazine to create the strange concoction. Let the Dogs Out is described as a toasted buttered bun ice cream with medallions of caramelized Nathan's all beef hot dogs. The shop is selling scoops tomorrow for curious taste testers in New York. Glad I live in LA. Now taking a look at KFI traffic, we've got a crash on the 215.
In Riverside, on the southbound side of the 215 before Center Street, this crash has only the right lane open, and they're now saying this is a fatal crash. Unfortunately, it's set to jam the whole back to Barton Road. Downtown LA, the 101 northbound at Alameda crashed in the two left lanes as you backed up to the 10 freeway, and the ongoing problem in Newhall, the northbound side of the 5, just at the 14. All lanes shut down there due to a crash of car versus a pedestrian. You're back up to the 210 freeway. And through Castaic, northbound side of the 5 before the brake check area, only the left lane open due to a fire. KFI in the sky helps get to there faster. I'm Robert Kubucki.
Here's a question I get asked a lot these days. Do we need an emergency backup generator for our home or business? Well, you know I can't really answer that for you, but here's what I can tell you. Losing power at home means losing the internet, the fridge, and the air conditioner probably right when you need them the most. Losing power in your business could mean losing data and definitely losing revenue when you shut the doors because you can't run the registers or anything anymore. More importantly, generators cost way, way less than any of the alternatives. So, if you've ever thought about getting a generator, or if you already have one, there's only one answer that I give to the generator question: Duffy Power. Duffy Power is your emergency power solution. If you need a new generator, you call Duffy. You already have one, then you need to keep that bad boy running reliably with Duffy's regular maintenance program. New or existing, home or business, the answer is always Duffy Power. To learn more, go to DuffyPower.com, DuffyPower.com, that's D-U-T-H-I-E, Power.com.
Southland weather from KFI, low clouds and fog by the coast, then sunny in the afternoon, mid-60s to low 70s at the beaches, mid-70s to low 80s in metro LA and OC, low to mid-80s in the inland valleys, and upper 80s to low 90s in the inland empire. Temperature's going to cool down slightly tomorrow, going to stay a little bit cooler, just a little bit cooler, through the Independence Day holiday. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Brian Berman. You're always using your personal information for just about everything, especially when you're online. And with all that information floating around out there, it can make the internet a practical gold mine for identity thieves to steal your identity. Well, now it's easy to protect yourself with LifeLock. This is what I do. LifeLock by Norton. LifeLock monitors your information and alerts you to potential identity threats, and there's lots of them out there. And if you're a victim of identity theft, a dedicated U.S.-based restoration specialist will work to fix your problem. Identity thieves have had it way too easy for far too long. Now it's your turn. No one can prevent all ID theft or monitor every transaction at every business, but save up to 25% off your first year with LifeLock. Call 800-LIFELOCK, use the promo code HANDLE, 800-LIFELOCK, promo code HANDLE, or visit LifeLock.com, promo code HANDLE. 25% off your first year, LifeLock.
Everyone deserves a second chance at life. And Bruce is that perfect redemption story. In her directorial debut, Oscar-winning actress Halle Berry plays Jackie Justice, a disgraced MMA fighter who's on a mission to reclaim her life. This is a classic fight movie, told from the perspective of a single mother. Go stream it now. And find out why it landed number one on Netflix.
Spinsleep wants to help you celebrate living and sleeping in the best country in the world.
So during our independent sale, save up to $1,000 off select mattresses from Sealy, Beautyrest, and Kingstown.
Right, Drew. Plus, with your good credit, pay 0% financing for 24 months with your minimum monthly payment. And save up to $500 on Tempur-Breeze mattresses and Purple Sleep Systems.
You're killing me, Larry! And you're not helping either, Drew!
So this independence holiday, trust your sleep to Sit and Sleep.
This is Jacob Amrani. If you've been in an accident, call 844-24-JACOB.
KFI AM 640. The news, what it means, why it matters.
AM 640, live everywhere on the iHeart Radio app. You're home. Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer. Hey, thanks for joining us today. On this, route where we are, a misty Saturday morning of Independence Day weekend, the long Independence Day weekend. That's awesome. If you're joining us from across the country, welcome. Hope your weather is looking like a great 4th of July weekend. And if you're listening on the podcast, it may not even be July. That's fine. I'm glad you're here. I'm glad you're listening. We're talking about clearances today. Critical clearances when you are planning your remodel, your renovation, or just building your new place. Things you need to know about so you don't mess it up, okay? Because design matters most. I say it every week in all sorts of different contexts. Because it's true. We're also taking calls, and I promised when we came back that we would go to the phones, and that's exactly what we're gonna do. Let's go to the phones. Nancy, welcome home.
Hi, good morning, Dean. Thank you so much for your show. You're a godsend to us that don't know what we're doing.
Happy to help.
Thank you. We are moving from the San Fernando Valley to the Simi Valley. And we have a house that has a large lot with a lot of grass. And since you can only water once a week in Ventura, we're thinking of going with desert state. So I need to know, how do I vet someone who's going to landscape? What questions do I ask? Do I check references? Do I get free quotes? What do I do, Dean?
All right, Nancy, I'm going to tell you. Just calm down. No. okay, so first of all, congratulations on your move to Ventura County. You're going to enjoy it. We live in Ventura County, so you're actually moving closer to us. I'm not going to tell you how close, though. Anyway, first of all, just for everybody who's listening, everybody in Southern California who is under water crisis restrictions, I want to direct you back a couple weeks. Has it been 2 or 3 weeks now, Tina? Because the passage of time is a mystery to me. A couple weeks back to when we spent the entire weekend talking about the water crisis and how, in fact, people can still have green turf lawns, not necessarily all grass, but green verdant lawns out in front of their homes during the 1 day a week watering restrictions. So it's not just one simple thing that can be done, but you can do it. I promise it can be done. So I'm going to direct you back to that weekend of shows and just look on the podcast a few shows back. Look for the water crisis show, the green lawn show. Anyway, everything else that you've got going. So, Nancy, I would encourage you, number one, listen to that information before you just decide to desertify, to go desert scape with your house. Now, as being against desert scaping a house, no, I'm not. I'm not against desert scaping a house because I'm a home designer, when it matches and coincides well with the design of the house. That is why I've gone through all these lengths to try and help people understand how they can have green, beautiful landscaping without the desert effect. Because if you've got a Tudor house that looks like it belongs on the English countryside, I'd rather not have cacti growing in front of it. That's the point. So that's up to you, your call, but I would encourage you to look at all your resources first. As for the rest of it, it sounds like you've got a great sense of what needs to be done. Yes, you're going to vet landscape contractors. And I want to be really, really serious about answering this question, Nancy. There is a shortage, a severe shortage of real landscapers, real gardeners in Southern California. Southern California, many, many moons ago has sort of just resorted to the mow and blow gardening companies because of the cost, because they're cheap. I say mow and blow, and that's fine to just kind of maintain a thing and cut some things back, but you will find so many, many so-called landscape companies that really don't know how to design a landscape, how to massage a landscape, how to handle the nuances of a landscape. So, yeah, I'm not going to blow smoke at you. It could be a tricky thing finding these days in any area, in any region in SoCal, really, really good gardeners. But that's what you want to do. Now, if you decide to pull the grass out, that landscape company can handle the entire thing for you. In fact, some DIYers do it themselves. These days, you can go down to like a tool rental yard and get a sod cutter to rent that is like a push behind mower, basically, that will cut the grass out of your lawn for you. But landscape companies will do it. Those that know exactly what they're doing. Yes, you want to see their work. You want to vet them, you want referrals, recent referrals. And this is true of all contractors, by the way. Recent referrals. All contracting when it comes to residential stuff is relatively small businesses, right? Small businesses. And that's a beautiful thing because you can get a lot of customized care and build a real great relationship with a company. If there's a downside to a small business, like a small boat on the ocean, a small business can often be subject to the waves of life and change and what have you. If the owner gets sick, then a small business can really turn its direction for a while. So when I say references, that's fine. If somebody wants to give me a referral for a yard that they did 10 years ago, that's great. That's fantastic, especially if they think it's a jewel that they really want you to see. But I am more interested in the clients you have right now and the landscape that you did just last month. Those are the ones that I want to see, because not only is it going to give me an example of your work, but it's also going to demonstrate for me the current condition, the state of the union, as it were, of your company and how things are working right now, which is when, of course, I want you to do the work. So, you got it right, Nancy. Multiple estimates, really good design, and yes, I would encourage you to talk to a landscape designer as well, because design matters most. So, I hope this helps. I think you're headed in the right direction. The only thing I'm going to encourage you to do first is not immediately jump to the desert scape unless that is just your heart's desire. There are other ways of doing it, especially if the lawn, quote unquote, that we imagine, I say the word lawn and we all instantly think of grass. If we want a green, beautiful, verdant lawn, but we don't need to functionally have it as grass. In other words, we don't have to have space for the dogs to roll around in or for the kids to play football on every week. Then there are so many great drought-tolerant green alternatives that would grow better, not need mowing, stay green all year long, and use way, way less water than the municipal water district is even asking us to cut back to. So you have options. Nancy, thanks for the call, and good luck to you on your move out to SEMA. All right, when we return, let's take a couple of more calls if we can, and then we'll get back to our clearances. Sound good? You're home with Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer, Brian Berumen.
So the city of L.A. is holding a fireworks buyback event at Grand Park starting at 9 this morning. You can get gift cards in exchange for fireworks. The woman who killed her pimp when she was 16 years old and spent 20 years in prison has been pardoned by Governor Newsom. And the trial for suspended L.A. City Council member Mark Ridley Thomas on bribery charges has been delayed until November. We're going to take a look at some trouble on the 5 next.
I've been telling you about how WDC Kitchen and Bath Center has pricing and appliances of in stock that just literally cannot be found anywhere else, how they're the answer to supply line delays and price increases. And right now, for even more savings, WDC is having its Independence Day sale, up to 40% off select appliance brands, 25 to 50% off select bath and plumbing fixtures, and 18 months no interest financing. Now, all WDC locations are open all weekend. They're going to be closed on July 4th, but that's not going to matter because you're already home with your great deals. For more details and to find the WDC nearest you, go to WDCAppliances.com, WDCAppliances.com.
July 4 savings are heating up, so you Lowe's. Protect your soil with Scott's Naturescapes mulch, 3 for $10. Lowe's, home to any possibility. Valid 6/30 through 7/6 while supplies last. Selection varies by location, excludes Alaska and Hawaii.
SoCal weather brought to you by driveway.com. Temperature is going to cool down to the upper 80s for the inland valleys for tomorrow and the 4th of July holiday. This report brought to you by Lowe's. Now taking a look at KFI traffic, we have a crash on the 5.
Newhall on the northbound side of the 5, just past the 14. It's all lanes that are still shut down here due to a crash of the car versus the pedestrian, and it's got you jammed back before the 210. Then through Castaic on the northbound side of the 5 before the brake check area, only the left lane open due to a car fire that turned into a brush fire as well, and it's got you back there before Teplin Highway. Downtown LA, the 101 north and an Alameda crash there on the 2 left lanes, causing delays from the 10. And in Riverside, a fatal crash investigation now on the 215 south of 4th Center Street has only the right lane open. You're jammed back to Barton Road. KFI in the Sky helps get there faster. I'm Robert DeBucky.
Sponsored by Allstate. Saving money feels pretty good. Allstate. Better protection costs a whole lot less. Visit Allstate.com or call an agent for a quote today.
The uncertainty in the world is leading to market volatility. My friends at Legacy Precious Metals are here to walk you through why gold is the way forward through these unsteady times. Legacy Precious Metals can advise you how to roll your existing retirement account into a gold IRA and provide steps to take should you want to hold physical metals in your home. Call Legacy Precious Metals at 866-806-3646. That's 866-806-3646. Or download your free investor's guide at legacypminvestments.com.
Giving it your all on the court? Make sure you have the right partner by your side. Highland's Leg Cramps Quick Dissolve Tablet. America's number one leg cramp relief solution for over 10 years. No water needed. No stomach upset. Just fast, effective relief. Also available in tablets. Highland Leg Cramps, the healthy competition and beyond. Available at Walmart, Walgreens, and CVS. Claims based on traditional homeopathic practice, not accepted medical evidence, not FDA evaluated.
With temperatures heating up, water is on everybody's mind for more than one reason here in Southern California. So let's talk about a great water story. Let's talk about Life Source Whole House Water System. Tina and I got ours years ago. Why? Because we wanted what everybody wants from the water in their house. You want to go to a faucet, any faucet. You want to turn it on, and out comes clean, delicious drinking water. No chlorine, no harsh chemicals. And from a five-star service company, end of story. Life Source Whole House Water System use proprietary technology and are completely, completely maintenance-free. That's why Life Source is recognized as America's most recommended water system. And right now, in celebration of July 1st, Life Source will pay your sales tax. You can take advantage of huge savings, but this offer ends soon, so ask today. Call Life Source Water at 800-803-2696, 800-803-2696, or visit lifesourcewater.com. Life Source Water, taste the difference. If you're a valued customer, you deserve a simple gesture of appreciation from your credit card company, and that's where Discover matches all of the cash back you've earned at the end of your first year. Discover, exceptionally common sense. Learn more at discover.com/match. Limitations apply.
The Project World Podcast takes you back in time to 1993 for the ultimate Voyage World rewatch. Join original cast members Danielle Fischel, Will Friedle, and Ryder Strong as they relive every episode, sharing memories, behind-the-scenes info, and more.
None of us can see an episode since it aired back in the 90s. So we'll be witnessing our middle part haircut, putting t-shirts and overacting for basically the first time right along with you.
Listen to Podbeat World on the iHeartRadio app or wherever you get your podcasts.
Today, my first injury settlements are often up to 10 times the original insurance company offers, which is totaled more than $1 billion over our proud history. So if you've been injured, don't just settle for better. Be 10 times better with Jacoby & Myers. Call us at 800-992-2222.
Big news! Greta Van Susteren is back, and she's on Newsmax. Tune into Newsmax at 6 p.m. Eastern tonight to watch The Record with Greta Van Susteren and get the real news. Plus, check out the new lineup of Rob Smith, Eric Balding, and more. Newsmax is on all major cable and streaming platforms. If your cable system doesn't carry Newsmax, call them and demand it. And download the free Newsmax app on your phone. Make the switch to Newsmax today. This is the real deal. Pinkwood Roger Waters, this is not a drill. North American tour rolls across the U.S.
How would you like to join me?
Here's your chance to win front row tickets to see Roger Waters in concert at T-Mobile Arena.
Wow.
Plus, attend sound check, take home an autographed guitar, and more from AEG. Text the nationwide keyword, Waters, to 200-200. You'll get a confirmation text and info. Standard data and message rates apply with nationwide contest. That's Waters. It's 200.
I know the weight of the world seems to rest on your shoulders, and sometimes life seems like a sail only with confusion and chaos. But I assure you, I have a plan for you.
Tomorrow morning at 6 on
KFI. More stimulating talk.
Start the house with for welcome home. Thanks for joining us on the program. We're talking about critical clearances and dimensions you need to know as you're working out the designs of your remodel or your addition or your new home or what have you. We'll get back to that in just a bit, but right now, as is our custom, we are taking calls. So let's get back to the phone. David, welcome home.
Yeah. Coffee time.
Absolutely. Hang on, wait. Okay, thanks for reminding me. All right, go for it. I'm ready.
Well, this is a clearance question. I was listening the other day and you didn't address it. I'm doing a 50-gallon water heater in a reconfigured laundry room, and I don't know what the clearance is. I'm sort of a Luddite. I don't know where to go for the destination.
Going
in the corner.
Okay. Well, here is the story with water heaters and clearances. It can be a kind of confusing. If you go on the interweb, you're going to find all sorts of different sources telling you all sorts of different things. So it's like, all right, what's the deal, man? So here's the deal. Here's the straight truth, as it were. The state of California has a default clearance for water heaters. Okay, the default clearance, and this is pretty much a common convention across the U.S. The default clearance for gas water heaters is 12 inches all the way around the water heater. Okay, now I say default. Why do I say that? Because the state of California, and I can't speak for other states on this, but the state of California distinguishes between lifted and unlifted water heater brands and models. Now, what that means is, if it is a lifted brand, which all the major ones are, by the way, if it's a lifted brand, that means it has had independent outside certification as to what the clearances need to be. And as a result, the state says, hey, if you're lifted, if you're certified, UL lifted, whatever the install instructions for that water heater are, go with that, that's fine. You follow those install instructions. Which means for a lot of water heaters, they're like, hey, we only need an inch or two clearance around this tank and a foot or anywhere from 6 inches to a foot in front where the gas is actually going to fire up to have combustion air space in front. So that's why quite often you'll see water heaters really kind of snugged in. Now, you got to have ample room or, sufficient room around it to, do maintenance, to reach around the back of the water heater, that kind of thing. But that whole 12 inches all the way around, that's the default.